The tribal playstyle is as old as the game of Magic itself. Lord of Atlantis, Goblin King, and Zombie Master were the first tribal creatures and have paved the way for the tribal decks we know and love today. Over the last 25 years of Magic's history, a lot has changed, and now there are more tribes than ever before. I'm your friendly neighborhood host, Alex, and today I'll be covering the basics of tribal magic in EDH and how to get the most out of your tribal deck. The fundamental difference between a weak and a strong tribe is numbers. Tribes like elves or zombies that have very large creature pools give you plenty of options for how you can go about setting up your deck. They also have a multitude of commanders with varying color identities that give you the flexibility to play in a way that suits you best. A magical thing happens when you combine a large synergistic tribe with a powerful commander. Just ask anyone who's had to take on an army of angry goblins or a horde of fire-breathing dragons. The top-tier tribes of the multiverse distinguish themselves by being bigger, badder, and faster than everyone else. These are just a few examples of the biggest, baddest tribes out there. If your goal is to build the most consistent, flexible tribal deck possible and have the ability to conquer your playgroup, these are the kind of tribes you're going to want to look at. Unfortunately, not all tribes are created equal. Mid-tier strategies tend to have smaller card pools and weaker creatures overall. They can also be inhibited by their color scheme or their lack of decent commanders to lead the tribe. That shouldn't stop you from building any of these tribes, though. If you're willing to put in the work to playtest your strategy, optimize it, and improve it over time, you can definitely keep up with the top-tier tribal decks. At the very bottom of the tribal totem pole, we have our low-tier tribes. These guys try, they really do, but they're still terrible. Very limited card pools, few if any capable commanders, these are the kind of tribes you play for fun. If your goal is to kick ass and take names, these tribes aren't gonna cut it for you. However, if you're somebody out there who's built a janky tribal deck, I applaud you, sir. You are awesome. If you have some empty holes in your tribal lineup, the changelings are here to fill those spots. The changelings are some of the weirdest looking creatures you're ever going to see. They might not win any beauty contests, but the changelings sure will do a lot of work in some of the smaller, more obscure tribal decks out there that need a few more bodies on the front line. The best of the changeling bunch is definitely these three uglies right here. Mere Entity can turn a small army into a pretty formidable one. Taurian Mauler is absolutely stupid in a multiplayer commander game. Just imagine all the 1-1 counters you can get on this guy. And of course we have Chameleon Colossus, every green player's fantasy, a big thing that smashes stuff. Adaptive Automaton, Metallic Mimic, and Brass Herald are some handy artifact creatures that can make any tribe a little stronger. You can also utilize clone creatures that can enter the battlefield or become a copy of a creature you control of a certain type. But maybe you're a mad scientist who wants to whip up some creatures in a lab. Well, there's plenty of options out there for you too. But let me guess, you're one of those people who likes to watch the world burn, in which case you have enchantments like Arcane Adaptation, which allow you to add a few merfolk to your bird tribal deck and then have those merfolk also be birds. Pretty wild. When building your tribal deck from the ground up, the first place to start is the lands. There are a couple of lands out there like Cavern of Souls or Path of Ancestry that are great for multicolored decks. They can tap for any color and give you some cool bonuses. There are also tribal specific lands. Now, depending on the tribe you're running, these are a fantastic way of solidifying your mana base. And if you're looking to hop aboard a tribe that has really high mana cost creatures, like angels or dragons for instance, cards like Urza's Incubator are invaluable. There are also the lesser known cost reducers, like the Banner Rays. It might not seem like much, but trust me, that one colorless mana difference can mean casting multiple creatures per turn instead of just one. Maybe you're too cool for cost reducers, and instead you want to cheat your tribe onto the battlefield for free. Now, if your tribal deck has a splash of green in it and you aren't running Descendant's Path, what are you doing? This card is so good. In the same vein as Descendant's Path are the ridiculous artifacts Belby's Portal and Cryptic Gateway. When you see one of these hit the battlefield, you better remove it or run, because you're in a lot of trouble. All the creatures in the world are great, but if we don't have a few ways to protect them, we're gonna have a hard time. A personal favorite of mine is Steely Resolve. Giving your entire tribe Shroud for only 2 mana is pretty legit. There are also options like Kindred Boon, which allow us to make certain members of our tribe indestructible, or Harsh Mercy and Kindred Dominance. These cards are a little more brutal. We're going to wipe out the other creatures on the table and keep our tribe intact. And of course, it's important to be prepared for the inevitable board wipe. The best of the bunch when it comes to these spells is definitely Patriarch's Bidding. Having the option to choose a specific creature type, then return all of those cards directly to the battlefield is absolutely brutal. No tribe would be complete without their fair share of lords. Lord creatures buff up their fellow tribe mates and overall improve the strength of your tribe. Most tribes are built on the backs of 1/1 or 2/2 creatures. A lord enables you to power those creatures up and make them much more formidable threats. There are also a handful of very powerful anthem artifacts and enchantments that can drastically improve the power of your creatures. An artifact like Coat of Arms, for instance, is well known for straight up ending games if it resolves. Oftentimes, artifacts like Door of Destinies or Obelisk of Urd, or even a smaller anthem effect like Shared Triumph, can be exactly what you need to get that last bit of damage through to give your tribe the win. No matter what tribe you side with, we can all agree on one thing. Tribal is one of the coolest ways to experience Magic the Gathering. Thank you for tuning in to the second installment of my strategy guide series. If you want to support the growth of my channel, hit that like button and don't forget to share the video. And you know what's up. Stay classy, deck builders. I'll see you next time.